Morning to all of you. In this video, I am going to discuss about gene therapy and cell-based therapy for the CVS disorder. So what is this gene therapy and cell-based therapies? Gene therapy is the transfer of gene where we will transfer into a therapeutic cells for the preventions as well as for the treatment of the disease. So for prevention or treatment of disease, we are using transfer of gene into a therapeutic cells, that is the gene therapies for any disease. And first successful gene therapy was attempted or completed in 1989. The successful gene transfer is done in 1989, and for it, because I told you it's a transfer of gene, so something is required to transfer that particular gene. So to transfer the genes, the thing which is required is be called vector. So vector is required for the transfer of the genes, and these vectors are of two types, viral and non-viral vectors. So there are various steps by which this gene transfer of gene is happened into the therapeutic cells. So first step is engineering means you have to be engineered a new gene. You have to be injected into a viral envelope if you are using a viral based vector. So you have to be in engineering new genes. A new gene is injected into a viral envelope. This is the first steps. You have to do in the lab, and then second step is you have to do integrations. And integrations means gene is integrated into the viral vectors. So this gene is integrated into viral vectors. This is the second step. Third step in a gene transfer is you have to be now this gene integrated with the viral vectors. Now next step is you have to be administered this thing, administrations, and you have to administer this modified vector into the patients. So this administrations where into the patients, particularly through IV routes or IM injection depending upon your requirements. And after administrations into the patients, the next step, what happens, binding the vector binds to the where the vectors in which the gene, modified gene, is injected. This vector is bind to the patient cells. Then this fifth step is packaging. Then vector is packed into the vesicles. This is the cells. If first is the binding, first step is binding, it will bind after the administrations, and after binding it's a packaged into the vesicles. So this is packaged into a vesicle, and next step is there is a breakdown. So next step is breakdown, and this vesicle which store the vector, this is breakdown, and ultimately vector is released. And the released vectors will help to insert new gene into the DNA. So this vectors will help inject gene into the nucleus. So these steps we called final results, breakdown, or there is a injections. So this is the final steps, and desired gene is injected into the nucleus. So after that, cell will make a protein by using a new gene. So cell now make a protein using injected gene, that is a new gene, using new gene. So this is steps in the gene therapies. What are the overview of the steps, how this gene is transferred? So again, I am repeating, gene therapy is the transfer of gene into the therapeutic cells for the prevention or treatment of the disease. And what are the steps? Because it's a transfer of the genes, so something is required, that is something which is required is vector. So first is engineering. In the lab, you have to be injected, new gene is injected into the viral envelope if you are using a viral vector. Then next step is integration. This gene is integrated into the viral vector. Now it's a prepared for the administration. So this prepared gene in the viral vectors, you have to administer it into the patients. And after administration into the patients, it will bind with the target cells. And there it will package, will happen within the vesicles, then vesicle breakdown and release the vector. And this vector release, or this vector transfer the particular gene of the interest into the nucleus. Now nucleus with new gene will make a new protein by using a new protein. So this is particularly the steps in the gene therapy. So in CVS, cardiovascular disease, as you know, there are a number of cardiovascular disease and their pathogenesis is also complex. So how this gene therapy can help, in particularly in if one by one little bit we discuss about the ischemia. In ischemia research is going on, or clinical trial is also happened regarding gene therapies for the ischemia. This is what gene therapy they are giving: angiogenic growth factors they are injecting, VEGF. This is a VEGF is a heparin binding glycoprotein. This is angiogenic factors which is required for the angiogenic factors for the endothelial cells. So IM injections of intramuscular injection of VEGF, vascular endothelial growth factor 121, results in the lengthening of the arterioles and useful in the treatment of ischemia. Results has been showing the promising results. Another growth factors for the treatment of this one, so ischemia, fibroblast growth factors is also under investigations. That is we called FGF. For there is a atherosclerosis, as you know, atherosclerosis leads to a various heart disease and its etiology is unknown. There are various mechanism, means environmental factor, genetic factor. So genetic factors, patients with defective gene, with the defective enzymes which is vital for the suppose patients with defective enzymes which is vital for or required for lipoprotein metabolism. So lipoprotein will not metabolize and their lipid profile is increased and it will deposit in the artery and leads to the heart disease. So how gene therapy can help in these conditions? Gene transfer of DNA producing correct enzymes you can transfer. The which is transferred is ApoB mRNA. You need transfer to correct the defective enzymes which is required for the lipoprotein metabolisms. For heart failure, there are various target genes on which research is going on to treat the heart failure. Like genes are targets are sarcoplasmic reticulum, calcium ATPase 2A, sarcoplasmic reticulum, calcium ATPase 2A, that is SERCA 2A, right? Another target is stromal derived factor 1, that is SDF1. There is a adenyl cyclase 6 is another factors, adenyl cyclase 6, that is ADCY6. There is another targets S1 calcium binding proteins. So there are a number of targets which research is going on for the treatment of heart failure through gene therapy, calcium binding proteins, A1, right? So there are a number of these ones, and barrier in cardiovasculars means what are the problem or what are the challenges. Just going to, okay, so challenges are, first challenge which has to be clear is in CVS is the gene vectors should able to pass the endothelial barrier. Gene vector, the vector which we are using, the vector which you are using should be able to pass the endothelial barrier. If it's not passed, so how it will transfer the required gene to the target cells, right? So it should pass the endothelial barrier when you are injecting IAV or IM, and the plasmid which you are using, it's always a challenge to protect the plasmid from the immune systems. So immune system can do the degradation, so it's a challenging system to protect it from the degradations from the immune system. Another challenge is it should not be entrapped into the lysosome where it will be degraded. So I told you it's degraded in the vesicles. So in vesicles there is lysosome enzyme which do the degradation of the vesicle. So it should not be entrapped in the lysosomes. It should be degraded there. It should not be trapped. If it traps, it will not going to deliver the particular gene of interest into the DNA. Another thing is we have to take care, gene vector should able to penetrate the nuclear membrane penetrations. So these are the things which is required to successful gene transfers. I forgot to tell you about the viral and non-viral vectors. There are two types of vectors which are used in the gene therapies. One is viral and another one is non-viral. These are the vectors we are using. In viral, vectors are adenoviral, there is a lentiviral HIV-1 we are using, particularly for this one is using for the CVS, and non-viral are plasmid and cationic lysosome, liposome, cationic liposome. These are the vectors, and these problems with these vectors, particularly viral, eradication of latent human protein, or there is a chances of mutation also which can lead to a sickle disease also. So this is the challenges with viral vector. So what now it is, I hope you people have heard about a new technology, or you just go through a much more detail about the CRISPR and many gene editing. This is a emerged technique and very good technique, and open a new door for the gene transfer, CRISPR gene editing. Just read about much more detail about it. Many online websites are providing online certificate courses also. So this is about the gene transfers. And if you ask me, sir, is there any drugs which are available on gene transfer? There are drugs which are available in the market. There is Zolgensma, is a drugs which is used for the treatment of, I'm not talking about CVS, treatment for spinal muscular atrophy. Muscular atrophy, may be called SMA. But problem with gene therapy is the particularly the cost is very high. It's not economical, very high cost. There is another drug, Luxtura. They are injected directly into the patient retina cells, that genes are injected particularly directly into the retina to correct the blindness, particularly the blindness of the child. So this drug is also available. another things which I think in class in immunopharmacology I have discussed about cell-based therapy, and well-known example of cell-based therapy is which I have discussed in immunopharmacology is chimeric antigen receptor T cell therapy, that is a CART therapy that we have completed. I have completed in that immunopharmacology units, and this is a well-known example of cell-based therapies, how it can be used and what are the challenges. So thank you. This is about the gene therapies for the CVS disorder. Thank you.